हेलो डियर फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज के डी आहिरे एंड करंटली वी आर स्टडिंग द रूरल एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप डेवलपमेंट द सर्टिफिकेट कोर्स ऑफर बाय द बीबीए डिपार्टमेंट केटीएचएम कॉलेज नासिक अंडर द स्कीम ऑफ यूजी स्ट्राइड. इन आवर टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द प्रोजेक्ट आइडेंटिफिकेशन एंड सिलेक्शन. बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द प्रोजेक्ट आइडेंटिफिकेशन एंड सिलेक्शन, डियर फ्रेंड्स, हियर वी आर गोइंग टू जस्ट टेक द वेरी short overview of what we have studied in our previous session. In our previous session, we have studied about the various business opportunity identification techniques, which we can identify the appropriate opportunities and we should select the proper business for us. So about the today's session agenda. So in our today's session, we are going to deal with very important topic, that is project identification and selection. So the learning objective behind our today's session, that is the learner will make aware about the project identification and selection, basically how to identify the project and how to select the relevant project in which we can start our business. So dear friends, let's start the project identification and selection. So in project identification and selection, basically the assessment of the project idea has been done. So here we know that in our previous session we have already studied how to identify or how to select the appropriate ideas and appropriate opportunities for our business. So here the assessment of our project ideas is very, very important to select the appropriate project. So here the assessment of project ideas and later on selection of project. So first, before selecting any project for our business, here we have to make the in detail assessment of the ideas, right? So after making the in detail assessment and after doing the detail analysis of our idea, then we can able to select the appropriate projects. Unless and until you go for the assessment of the ideas, here we will not able to identify or select the proper or relevant project for us. So in project identification and selection, the assessment of the project idea can be done. So here screening of the project ideas, right? So in the assessment, the screening can be done. And later on, we can able to identify the appropriate and accurate project for our business. So how to do the screening of the projects? So here, screening can be done on the various basis. So on the various criterias, we can do the screening of the project ideas. So here, first is the cost of ideas. So here, obviously, whenever we are trying to implement any kind of business, or whenever we are thinking to start any kind of business, and we have various ideas in our mind, and we will try to incorporate those ideas, and we always try to make our idea in reality. But here we have to do some kind of analysis, either our ideas are really feasible or not. We in future we really able to convert our ideas in into reality or not. So therefore, the various kinds of assessment can be done, in which first there is the cost of ideas. So here we have to analyze what is the cost. Actually, it may be capital investment, right? Even here we are able to find out the cost of our ideas is in our within a capacity, right? Or it is feasible, right? We can easily able to invest the money, and even we are also able to get the funds from it may be through the government scheme or maybe from banks, right, in the form of loans. So here the cost of ideas is to identify the cost of ideas is very, very important. So here we have to make the analysis of our idea with respect to the cost, right? And here all types of financial inputs or outputs can be considered in the analysis of the idea with respect to the cost of idea. Even risk involved. So what type of risk are involved in our ideas? It may be various types of risk. It may be, for example, here we may start our business, right? We have started the business, but here the we may not able to find out the proper customer. So here demand of our product or maybe for our services is not there in the market. So you may find out various kinds of risk are involved. Even for example, in future, even you have started the business right now, but in future maybe government policies are changing. So again, these are the risk, right? So many kinds of risk are there. So here we have to make the again in detail assessment of the what types of risk are there, right? And even the risk may be arise or maybe risk is there, but ultimately yes, we have capacity, either we can able to face these problems, and even risk will be there, but how we are going to deal with all these risk and all these problems, right? So here the risk identification is again very, very important step in the screening in the project idea. If we found that so many risks are there, and again so many obstacles and so many problems that may we are going to face in the future if we implement any particular idea. So again, the good thing is that we should avoid such types of ideas, right? Because even we implement these ideas, but in future we may face various types of problems, and again it may make directly somehow negative impact on our overall entrepreneurship process, or it may be on our business, or it may be on products or quality of products, even quantity of products. So overall our enterprise is going to be affected through if the so many risks are there. So ultimately, yes, we have already discussed in our initial session that entrepreneurs should be risk takers. But here the thing is that the risk should be a calculated risk, right? So we have to always find out the some kind of solution, right? We have to always go to the in detail analysis of the risk, and a risk should be a calculated risk. So always we have some kind of solution of these various risk. So risk, what type of risk involved in the our project ideas, that can be analyzed. Even returns if idea implemented, right? So if we are thinking, yes, if we have implemented this idea, so what type of returns get, right? Again, the analysis of the return can be done. So either if we are getting good amount of returns or not, or even if we implement this idea, so what type of returns we will get. So again, detailed analysis of the returns can be done of our project idea. Even does it mean a threat to life or property or group of people? Again, that is the thing. Again, the risk involved, that is again a part of risk involved. But again, here we are going to make some kind of separate assessment, right? If you implement any this idea, so either it will have any kind of threat to the life or property or group of people. For example, if we are thinking to start a business in to manufacture the hazardous chemical, right? So here again, if we are trying to manufacture the hazardous chemical, so it has the health related risk of people. Even it may have the a threat to the environment, right? Even property. So such types of study or analysis can be done of our ideas. Either if our business is involving any kind of threat to the property of group of people, so we have to take some appropriate actions, and again we have to look towards the various kinds of, again here we have various kinds of rules, regulations. So again, we have to again fulfill some kind of legal aspects are there. So this is again very, very necessary to study if our ideas have any kind of threat to the property or even people of or group property or group of people. Even investment, right? So here in a criteria for project selection, so screen can be done based on various characteristics or various types of aspects of our business ideas. Then criteria for selection of business, so what type of criteria can be considered if we want to select any kind of appropriate business for us or a project for us? So here the following some are important criteria can be considered while selecting the appropriate project. So first is the investment, right? So here first thing that we need to consider as the investment. So what type of investment can be invested in our projects? So it may be sometime it may be happen. So again, we are dreaming to start very big business or big project. We have various types of ideas in our mind and everything we have, but we are lacking in investment, right? Because here we have not sufficient fund in our hand, or even we are not able to find out the sponsor or the funding agencies, and even you have the appropriate ideas to have very good projects, business ideas, but again here you are lacking in the investment. So here we have to again consider the investment. What type of investment I have to do? It may be the investment is not in my capacity, or it is beyond my capacity. So again, we have to think on it. Even you are investing very huge money in your business, but your business is not a kind of business there you will not get the sufficient returns, right? So, or even it will take a very long time, a long period to get the returns. So many things are there, so many aspects are there. So investment is again important things that need to be considered, right? It is very, very important criteria. So based on the investment, we can able to find out again the sponsor, or even the appropriate schemes for our business, or even it will again very much it will make again very much very high impact on our in detail project report. So even the funding agency, for example banks, if you are seeking to take a loan from the bank, even bank will also they concentrate basically on the investment, what type of investment you are making in your business. So on the investment also, this funding agency may able to make the assessment of your business. So here you should have, as an entrepreneur, you should have the appropriate knowledge about the financial aspects of your business. So based on it, you can able to do very very accurate assessment of the investment. So here the first criteria for project selection, that is the investment, that rate of return. So again, here we have to initially calculate what type of the rate of returns if we implement this idea, right? If we select this idea, so what type of the expected rate of returns, right? So again, here the in detail study can be done through the expert, and here we have to find out the rate of return. Even risk, again what type of risk are involved in the projects. So again, here we have to consider, already I have mentioned that the assessment of the risk is essential, because without assessing the risk, and if we blindly start any kind of business, so here simply here we are not ready to face any kind of risk, right, or problems. And if any problem will arise, so it will totally collapse our entire business, right? So therefore, the consideration of risk is essential. If we initially anticipate the risk which involve in our business, so we can easily find out the solution for our these various risk also. So at initial level only we can do it. So again, the third important criteria for the selection of appropriate projects, that is the risk. Then profits. Again, here we have to do the again a study, or here the analysis of profits, right? So again, here we have to again do the cost benefit analysis also. Again, what type of profit we will gain in future if we select this project. So again, here in detail study about our projects can be done at this level. So through the analysis of the profit, right? So here we can able to find out the appropriate projects for us. Again, then payback. Here even if we invested the money in our business, so what will be the payback period, right? Again, that need to be considered. If we are investing the money in 2011, and if we, the payback period is 10 year, 15 year, 20 year, so again the various kinds of risk are involved in such things. So again, here we have to again consider the payback. Again, competitions. So again, that is this thing. So again, here so many entrepreneurs, they doesn't bother about the competitors. So they simply ignore the competitors and they don't study about the competitors. So again, here it is totally wrong. So study about the competitors again here, very very important in entrepreneurship, right? So here initial assessment can be done on the competitors, right? So here study of the competition and the consideration of the competition of our business, that is also a very important step in or it is important criteria for selection of appropriate projects. Because here the competitors are going to create various problem for you in future, if you have started your business. But if you are blindly started your business, and if you don't have any kind of idea of your competitors, so again you in future you will be in trouble. And because of you are lacking with the study of competitors, so it may have various kinds of negative impact on your business, and it will make the overall impact on your quality as well as quantity of your products or services. So therefore, at initial level only we have to consider the competition of our business. So if you are trying to implement or incorporate the ideas where you have very huge competition, so here you have to think differently. So here the solution of that, you have to think differently, and you have to study the what type of competition is there, and how I can do the different things, and how I can start my business with the different things. So you have to do some kind of you have some kind of uniqueness in your business, so customer in future customer will attract towards your products or services, right? So here consideration of the competition, again it is essential criteria in project selection. Again, similarity to existing business. So again, here we have to consider the what type of similarities are there in the existing business which are already in markets. So these studies again can be done by the entrepreneur at the initial level. Again, expected life, right? Here the expected life of our projects. So even again, to study the expected life, or to consider expected life, we have to consider so many factors. We have to study so many factors. Even the availability of raw material, even customer tendency, customer behavior, even government policies, right? Even international relation, even various rules, regulations, even trending change, technologies. So many aspects are there that we need to consider while studying the expected life of our. So here we are going to start the business, so our business should have the long life. So these things can be considered again one of the criteria of the project selection. So here, dear friends, in our today's this session, so we have gone through the various types of criterias, this thing again criterias for the selection of appropriate projects for our business. So in our today's session, the learner have learned about the project identification and selection criterias, which are very much useful and it's very essential to consider at the initial stage. So in our next session, we are going to study about the project formulation. Thank you.